So I finally got smart and decided to invest in this. And now you may be asking, what is this? What is this? Well, this is 8 planks of wood that I took from the shelves in this common room. Yeah, I basically raided this entire section. And hold on. Yep, nothing. No shelves left. But what exactly do I need these 8 shelves for? Well, let me explain real quick. Yeah, that's why I need them. Because this desk does not fit my height whatsoever.
Ever since the start of online school, and me personally, ever since I started making YouTube videos, I feel like I've been at my desk for 6+ hours every single day, staring at my laptop.
And once you do anything repeatedly for many hours a day for a long period of time, it starts to become the norm, such as hunching over your laptop to do work. Soon, this is gonna be the normal position of your back. And sitting up straight like this is gonna feel out of this world.
So you might as well make that extra effort and go get you some planks. You might only need 2, you might need 4, or you might need something as simple as a laptop stand.
And I don't mean to start this video off and just start preaching to you guys, but after being in discomfort for like 2 months straight, I finally got smart and started doing something about it. And I kinda wanna push you guys to do the same, invest in yourself, because this is something that is gonna affect us way down the line. It's not gonna affect you this year or next year. It might not affect you in the next decade, but definitely in the next 30, 40 years. You might be one of those old people that walk like this. But I'm at the cafeteria now, and I kind of want to continue the segment where I show you guys what I eat over here at the KU cafeteria, because the ladies just put in work. The lunch lady be showing me love, she be giving me double portions sometimes. And when I get double portions, it just makes me feel special. I'm walking around looking at people's plates like, yeah, looking like you didn't get a double portion. It's looking like you didn't get a double portion. I got a double portion. But anyways, let me show you guys what we have for lunch today. So first things first, we always have our soup for the day, and then we have a rice dish with some type of red curry sauce on top. And then we have these deep fried, I'm guessing chicken sticks with some type of jelly curry. And then we have a clear noodle salad. And then we have some pickled vegetables on the side, which are always key for any meal. Honestly, I don't know what any of this stuff is, but I know it's gonna be delicious. Mmm. That's amazing. Super seasoned to the point where it's making my tongue tingle, but it's not necessarily spicy. So I'm back at the dorm now and I just finished up my 3 classes for the day. But while I'm getting ready for this photo shoot, I wanted to show you guys the biggest mistake I made while packing to get to Korea. And it wasn't this pair of shoes, wasn't this pair of shoes, wasn't this pair of shoes. It might have been this pair of shoes, but it was this pair. These are the Bottega puddle boots. And these things are basically the most uncomfortable shoe I've ever worn in my life. And before coming to Korea, for some reason, I didn't know that Korea was just 2 things. Hills and walking. That's literally all Korea is. And these shoes have a 1-inch insole. So when you step on them, you're literally stepping on a platform. That's really what it feels like. This is my height without the puddle boots on. And this is my height with the puddle boots on. I'm literally 2 inches taller. I figured I would bust them out for the first time since I've been here because I'm going on this photo shoot. But there's this one more piece I need to complete this outfit, and it's waiting for me in main campus. So I'm gonna head there right now. Had to flex up, got my check up, I'm so special, yeah, yeah. Count your blessings, I'm the next one, ain't no best one, yeah, yeah. I'ma be this way all the way till I'm in a wheelchair. Talking to my friends, can't believe that we still here.
Ooh.
Here you are. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. And that very last piece was this, the KU varsity jacket. This is a staple to any university in Korea, not only Korea University. You gotta have the varsity jacket for your school, and I finally got mine. Whew, let's try this thing on, Yeah, it's funny because I almost didn't buy this, and I technically bought it by accident. I'm always saying that, but let me explain. So when it was time to buy these through the KU buddy system, my buddy ended up texting me all the details, and then he ended it off with, by the way, you guys don't have to buy these. And me, for some reason, jumped to the conclusion that that meant that I don't have to pay for it. But it was just, it was a slight misinterpretation of what he said. He honestly meant to say, you guys don't have to buy these if you don't want to. But me thinking it was free, immediately sent my information, and the next day, my buddy was like, yeah, do you guys, you want to meet up and give me the 55,000 won? And then I was like, what? But I'm happy that mistake happened anyway, because this bomber jacket is super dope. But the reason I didn't want to buy it is because literally every single student has one and they wear it almost every single day. And let me not tell you, let me just show you guys. It's hit, it's hit, it's hit, it's hit, it's hit, main campus now. As you guys know, I'm shooting film today. And film is one of my favorite things to shoot ever because it has that timeless look alongside a timeless looking campus, alongside the timeless looking bomber jacket. I think the aesthetic would just really be there. And for those of you who don't know, I also love shooting film. I have this old film camera, the Minolta XGA, literally the first Minolta ever made from like 1980. And I've shot for a couple years now.
Cussing the things, cussing the wings. I had to cuss in the vibe, cussing the link. Cover the back of the lie, front cover magazine.
But the thing is, it just got to the point where the camera was too old. And since it was so old, it was shooting a lot of blanks and it just wasn't really worth the money I was paying. All right, so I'm with my girl Missy now. The height difference though. I'm telling you guys, everyone has the bomber jackets. Missy has the black one on right now. But yeah, we're about to shoot some film. So I'm gonna describe you two guys the locations and why I'm choosing them. So kind of like my thought process behind taking all these photos. And of course, I'm gonna be showing you guys the final result. But what camera are you using and what film?
This is a Pentax K1000. And I think, I just put a new film today. I think it's Kodak Color Plus 200.
Okay.
That's what I put in. So we'll see how this turns out. I'm ready. Are you ready?
Yeah.
You good?
Of course I'm ready. Okay. All right. First location is literally right here. The banner of the KU Tiger with this
official.
And then the flowers in the background.
Location number one.
So location number two is another banner flower location. We're honestly just trying to catch the sun right now because it's basically sunset and the sun is poking through perfectly right here. That's kind of the key when it comes to taking photos. Honestly, you really have to just go during golden hour and that's when you're gonna get the best photos, like right here. Woohoo! That thing is poking.
Location number two.
Finding myself, showing myself, finding a way to stay out of the way.
Location number three, another sun poking scene with this beautiful tree right here.
Location number three.
Holding me back, supposed to come right back, guarding myself while I'm all on display.
Location number four is this bench location, once again, because the sun is poking through perfectly right here.
Oh yeah, golden right here.
Ooh. Last location right here. You guys already know where I'm at. Basketball court. The sun literally has been moving like crazy the 10 minutes we've been shooting, but a little bit is poking through still. I'm gonna try to get my boys in the picture with me. They're all playing basketball though. Yo, come take this picture with me. Location number six with my guys right here. I'm at the library right now, and I actually came here earlier to drop my bag off like 3 hours ago, and to no surprise, it's still over here. I kind of do this, it's kind of a life hack over here. So basically, it's a couple factors as to why people just leave their stuff everywhere. One, this guy literally has 3-4 different stands, like 6 different textbooks, 2 different pencil cases, because he's probably here for like 8 hours every single day. He's gonna have to go eat maybe twice, maybe use the bathroom like 4 times. It's just too much effort to pack everything up, and that's honestly a reason why people just leave their stuff around, because it's safe and it's okay to do so, no one's gonna take it. But I'm basically gonna spend another couple hours here trying to lock in on editing and work. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to smash the like button. And thank you for watching up until this point. It really means a lot. And also make sure to follow me on Instagram to see which pictures I end up posting from this film session. I'll put the link down below. Thanks again for watching. Peace out. Until next time, guys.